som alder! Everybody run, 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 run. Everybody scatter, scatter. Someone nearly died. Some people lost somewhere. Someone just died. Police, they come, army, they come. Confusion everywhere. Who is Adams Oshiomhole? A documentary by Edo Political Rebirth Movement, EPRIM. The Webster Dictionary defines deception as the act of deceiving, cheating, hoodwinking, misleading, or deluding. A deceptive leader resorts to falsehood in his attempt to avoid facts and public scrutiny. Such a leader will also design clever ways to deceive or delude his people in his desperate bid to defraud his state. A deceptive leader uses pretense and trick to evade the scrutiny of his followers. A deceptive leader will always play to the gallery. He will go to marketplaces to mingle with market women, while at the same time orders his task force to seize the wares of the poor market women. He is wicked and irritated by the poor and quick to insult them, like the poor widow, Mrs. Joy Ifeji, who Oshiomhole asked to go and die.
Where are you carrying the woman to?
You will be charged appropriately.
Retired Major Loye was handcuffed. To make what is obviously a public disgrace complete, the retired major was bundled into a waiting van.
I'm not a criminal, I've never been a criminal. Whenever they want to take me to, they will take me to. Because it involves this man, I'm not a shit and I cannot be intimidated.
A deceptive leader is a ruler that will set up oppressive agencies such as war against indiscipline. Why? As General Muhammadu Buhari did when he scuttled Nigeria's democracy in 1985 and charged them to confiscate goods, extort and beat innocent boys and girls, youths, market men and women who, because of the failure of government, are forced to undertake life-threatening trades to survive. This is the choreographed story on the 6 years anniversary of Edo State with Governor Adams Aliyu Oshiomhole as the ruler. Governor Adams Aliyu Oshiomhole is the third executive governor of the state through the benevolence of the judiciary, the Court of Appeal, on November 11, 2008, which upheld the election tribunal verdict of his victory in the April 14, 2007 governorship election in Edo State. On November 12, 2008, Comrade Adams Aliyu Oshiomhole took the oath of office, and he cleverly made several spurious promises in his inaugural speech.
I, Comrade Adams Aliyu Oshiomhole,
he immediately abolished ticketing, the local term used in Edo State for illegal collection of taxes and levies. Hear him.
Comrade, yesterday, as we were coming from the court, some young men looking as if this were really hard. They were shouting to my ears, Oga, no more tickets. I said, what is the ticket? And they told me, hello, I want you to listen to this, very important. I was told what they mean is that even the poorest among us, they are asked to pay taxes,
No more oppression and extortion of the poor. All manner of extortions and levies, other than legitimate and legal government taxes and levies, must stop immediately. All individuals and kingpins who in the past perpetrated these extortionist levels on our fellow citizens, whether in the markets, in transportation sector, in schools, or any other sector of livelihood, are called upon to cease such activities at once. We will deal ruthlessly with extortionists within the ambit of the law. Like a chameleon that keeps changing color, Governor Adams Aliu Osiomhole quickly flushed his promise down the drain.
We are protesting as a result of the increment in waste management. We were paying 70,000 naira before, they now increased it to 200,000, and we said we are not paying. We made a complaint and they've not replied us.
5 o'clock in the morning, before you enter your store, you will just say they put up sealed paper. When we go to police to ask what is this, the DPO we said is not aware of what is going on. He's supposed to get a copy that they are coming to seal up stores around this jurisdiction. So we now feel it is right time for us to protest the government house, so the government will know what we are facing.
The arbitrary increase every time from 300 to 500 to 1,000 and even more now. So we are saying no to it. So we want to see the community governor and tell him. So they have been extorting us for so long. You know, the other one, is it why also?
Why?
Whereas government say nobody should, no more street trading, but they encourage it.
We are saying no to it. Because we are saying no to it, they are coming to our shops with talks to seal up our shops. Sometimes to reopen our shops with 80,000 naira, with 100,000 naira. From the shop we earn our living. From the shop we pay our rentage. From the shop we pay our train our children. From the shop we are paying tax. We are paying waste management bond. From 300 naira, they are collecting 500 naira from us. From 500 naira, they are saying 1,000 naira.
When he failed to stop the same persons he identified as self-appointed godfathers and overseers, Osiomhole did not only empower these extortionists, who are members of the All Progressives Congress, APC, with the necessary equipment such as Hilux trucks and police protection, he went ahead to appoint them as his special assistants on revenue generation, who collect the pay-as-you-earn tax from drivers on behalf of Edo State Internal Revenue Service. Over 75 million naira payee tax is collected from drivers each month, and only 2 million naira is officially remitted to the Internal Revenue Service Board. The balance is shared between Governor Osiomhole, Chief Oseni Elama, Chairman IRS, and the agent. Chief Oseni Elama, who the governor appointed as Chairman Board of Internal Revenue, collects 4% of the total revenue generated by the state. Elama is Osiomhole's Man Friday on revenue collection. Even when Osiomhole was president of NLC, it was the same Oseni Elama who he recommended to preside over the NSTIF as managing director or revenue collector while Osiomhole was chairman. Investigations conducted at the Edo Board of Internal Revenue reveal that what is officially declared as IGR is a far cry from what is actually collected. There was a particular month, for example, where 2.2 billion naira was collected, but only 2 billion naira declared, while the extra 200 million naira was sent to the Oga at the top. While the tax law stipulates that 10% of the IGR be shared to the local government, Comrade Osiomhole has never complied. Rather, he continues to connive with his deputy governor, Honorable Pius Odubu, and Commissioner for Local Government, Chief Lucky James, to deduct millions from local government accounts, thereby making it impossible for these local governments to even pay salaries. Today, local government workers are owed arrears of 3 months' salary. No wonder Comrade Adams Osiomhole was in the forefront of governors that opposed financial autonomy to local government councils. Peasant farmers in Edo State are forced to pay tax of between 5,000 and 15,000 naira on every vehicle transporting tomatoes, pineapple, plantain, vegetables, and others to the Produce Task Force, which is headed by Governor Osiomhole's nephew, Romeo Aluaye Omoike, who until recently was his domestic aide. Romeo generates 30 million naira each month, which is shared between himself, Hosseini, and the governor. Several cries about the high-handedness of these task forces continue to fall on deaf ears for obvious reasons. The endless list of the taxes and levies collected on behalf of government but unaccounted for is responsible for the unfriendly business environment. Some of the ridiculous and illegal taxes collected by agents of Governor Oshiomhole include the offloading and loading tax and driver's pay paid daily by drivers, the granite haulage levy paid by tipping truck drivers each time they drive in and out of Edo State, and Ovia Northeast Local Government Council at Oluku near Benin City. The State House of Assembly has passed a resolution that made this levy unlawful. But Governor Adams Oshiomhole, true to his type, has remained silent because of his benefits from these illegal activities. The Tricycle Operation Levy, the Scrap Iron and Metal Haulage Levy, collected from truck drivers going in or out of Edo State. The Environmental Pollution Levy, collected by the Chairman of the Committee on Environment, and APC Youth Leader Signboard Levy, collected by agents of the State Ministry of Environment. And perhaps the most ridiculous, the Private Borehole Permit Levy. Governor Adams Aliyu Oshiomhole has institutionalized poverty in the state with series of his anti-people policies, including the over 26 different taxes and levies paid by businessmen and artisans in the state. Owners of hair barbing saloons, beauty saloons, provision stores, vulcanizers, newspaper vendors, fruit and food item sellers are harassed daily by agents of Edo State Ministry of Commerce. In Governor Oshiomhole's desperate bid to create avenue for APC leaders to extort Edo traders, he gave authority for the collection of street trading permit tax from those hustling on the streets of Benin City. Governor Adams Aliyu Oshiomhole has tried unsuccessfully to divert the public attention from the ugly sides of his corrupt practices with deceitful propaganda. Not anymore. Nigerians must know the essential Adams Aliyu Oshiomhole. It has now become public knowledge that many of the so-called protests that Adams Oshiomhole embarked upon as president of Nigeria Labour Congress were stage-managed with the powers that be to achieve their purpose of deceiving the Nigerian masses, while Oshiomhole smiled home to the bank for job well done. That was why on none of those occasions were fuel prices reversed by government to its original and old value. It was always a case of an arranged middle road. Oshiomhole often boasted of being in the forefront for the struggle to restore democracy in Nigeria. But investigations have revealed that he was a major beneficiary of military rule and had a godfather in the person of late Admiral Mike Ahigbe, his Etsako kinsman who assisted him to eventually become the NLC president. It is therefore no surprise that all through the dark days of General Sani Abacha, Comrade Adams Oshiomhole was unusually quiet. There is no evidence anywhere in Nigerian newspapers and magazines where Oshiomhole was quoted as saying the military and Abacha must go. While responding to Oshiomhole's accusation that General Ibrahim Babangida stole public funds while in office, Prince Kazim Afebua, IBB spokesman, now special advisor, media to Governor Oshiomhole, said Oshiomhole was not qualified to point accusing fingers at IBB. Hear him. Our initial inclination was to ignore Oshiomhole since we know that he is a political hireling. It will also interest the electorate to know how Oshiomhole came about his stupendous riches, particularly as a labor leader, to warrant his rather ostentatious lifestyle, much of which is done in pretense at the expense of the masses. Beyond the characteristic austere look of Oshiomhole lies his acquisitive demeanor, yet portraying a pro-masses labor leader on the one hand, while exploiting them on the other hand as an agent of the ruling elite. The masses have become more alert to the pranks of those who profess to be doing their bidding on the pretense and will be more than prepared to demand accountability when the time comes. Oshiomhole quickly brought Kazim into his government for fear of more damaging revelations. Edo people don't agree less with Kazim. Governor Adams Aliu Oshiomhole is not only a corrupt person, but he is also politically and morally bankrupt. In the words of the seasoned journalist and lawyer, Mr. Osa Director, Oshiomhole is the biggest scam created and promoted by the Nigerian media and unleashed on the Nigerian people. A quick review of Oshiomhole's financial recklessness in the last 6 years confirms that. 1. In 2011, Oshiomhole, through AfriInvest, collected 25 billion naira bond from the stock market. Is it true that a commission of 625 million naira paid by the state was shared between him and Godwin Obaseki, the managing director of AfriInvest? Does this not amount to double dealing and runs foul of corporate governance principles, since the same Godwin Obaseki doubles as chairman of Edo State Economic Team and Oshiomhole's personal investment advisor? The 500 million naira loan that was obtained from Bank of Industry, BOI, was inflated with 5% by the Commissioner for Finance on the instructions of the governor. We challenge Oshiomhole to deny this fact. Can Governor Adams Aliu Oshiomhole also deny that he recently bought 2 billion naira shares in one of the commercial banks? In 2012, Oshiomhole bought a property worth over $1 million in Cape Town, South Africa. Oshiomhole's property in California, USA was bought in 2011 at a staggering amount of $2.5 million shortly after Edo State government borrowed 25 billion naira through the bond deal by Godwin Obaseki's AfriInvest. 7. Just recently, Oshiomhole awarded a contract for the installation of streetlights on Sapele Road from 3rd East Secular Junction to Country Home Road, a distance of less than 2 kilometers for 600 million naira. Can Oshiomhole deny the fact that the contractor objected to the overinflated cost because of his fear of EFCC? Oshiomhole, acting on the advice of his economic team, Godwin Obaseki, to emulate General Olusegun Obasanjo, who built a presidential library with federal government money and later converted it to his personal property, forced members of the State Executive Council to approve the funding of a private university of technology in Yamo. We challenge Oshiomhole to deny the fact that he has appointed Mr. Hakeem Bello Osagi, Godwin Obaseki, and others as members of the Governing Council. If this is not fraud, what else is fraud? What has happened to the university Oshiomhole promised to establish in Edo South? The College of Education in Ekeadolo, which he announced he has upgraded to university status, is worse off today under Oshiomhole's tenure. There is no single infrastructure in place to back Oshiomhole's empty statement. Governor Adams Oshiomhole and the State Commissioner for Finance, John Inegbedion, must explain to Edo State how the over 500 million naira the excess COT refund from Equatorial Bank, which was facilitated by the first Deputy Governor of Edo State, Reverend Peter Obadan, an APC chieftain, vanished into the thin air. Governor Oshiomhole recently bought a property from Bob Oshodi. The property is located in Williams Avenue, GRA, Benin City. Our comrade must explain to Edo people where he got the 300 million naira he paid for the property. 2 years after finding his way to government, Oshiomhole acquired a block of flats in Dubai for $1.5 million in 2010. Again, we challenge Oshiomhole to tell Nigerians where this money came from. Oshiomhole has awarded the contract for school furniture to ETEX at a non-competitive price of 1.5 billion naira on each supply, despite complaints from the commissioners for education and teachers that the furniture are not durable. Can Oshiomhole deny the fact that his decision to use one contractor for all the school furniture in the state is unconnected with the 500 million naira that ETEX remits to him on the contract? Does Oshiomhole's decision to use an Abuja-based furniture maker in a state that prides herself as the leading furniture maker in Nigeria not amount to capital flight and counterproductive to the economy of Edo State? Oshiomole's multi-billion naira new home in his village, Iyamo, is on 10 acres of land with helipad where he lands, amphitheaters, artificial lakes and rocks, several swimming pools, as well as a zoo. This land of adventure was built by Verisimo, a South African architect, at the cost of 10 billion naira. Was it a coincidence that the construction of the Comrade Governor House at Iyamo started the same time the airport road contract was re-awarded to Setraco? Can Oshiomole deny the fact that the 35% he received from Setraco before he re-awarded the airport road contract was part of the funds he used for the building at Iyamo?
We want to know who owned the land. We want to know.
In 2012, Oshiomole spent 70 million naira to host Miss University Africa beauty pageant just to be intimate with the Namibian beauty queen, Miss Dilish Matthews, eventual winner of Big Brother Africa. Can Oshiomole deny the fact that Dilish later spent a weekend in his new mansion and that he showered her with $300,000 equal to her award-winning prize in BBA? In his desperation to become vice presidential candidate to Buhari, the Comrade Governor changed his name to Adams Eric Aliyu Oshiomole to emphasize his new Christian faith. But his deception didn't help him, as he also lost 500 million naira to a group of boys loyal to Senator Ahmed Bola Tinubu, APC national leader. Oshiomole has a record of being the most traveled governor in Nigeria, which made a disturbed son of Edo State, OSA director, to award him the Flying Saucer Governor of Nigeria, FSGN. While Governor Lucky Igminedion traveled 21 times in 4 years, Governor Oshiomole has already traveled 147 times in 6 years. Like they say, Nahu no man, they kill man. Prince Kasim Afegbua, special advisor on media to the governor, knows his master more than anyone else. It is usually very difficult for a man like Oshiomole to wear two caps. One has to give, and in this case, his present status as governor was manifest when he declared his support for the removal of subsidy, so that the masses that have given him all the support over the years would now pay through their nose. Since the governors were aware that subsidy removal meant more money accruing to their pockets, they sent one of their own, Comrade Oshiomole, to do the talking while they await the proceeds. And like a good dispatch rider, Oshiomole went to the Lagos debate to deliver the punches against the Nigerian masses, speaking from both sides of his mouth to be a friend of government and the masses. By the time he delivered the killer punch, Nigerian masses were completely devastated with shock. Power has a great allure. It makes men blind to their real intentions. It is understandably clear why Comrade Oshiomole, ACN, chose to be President Jonathan's PDP mouthpiece at the subsidy removal debate. It is very obvious that Oshiomole, a semi-literate unionist, has employed deception, hypocrisy, and iron fist to deceive Nigerians. We call on every man of good conscience to do everything possible to deconstruct this ingrate who pretends to be an apostle of openness and accountability in governance. Like APC's General Muhammadu Buhari and Senator Ahmed Bola Tinubu, Governor Adams Aliyu Oshiomole's educational background is shrouded in doubts and forgery. He has a definite date with the law. It is an aberration that a man that prides himself as people's governor will increase school fees by 100% in both Ambrose Ali University and the State School of Nursing without commensurate infrastructure to enhance the learning environment. It is difficult for Governor Oshiomole to keep his promises, not even to himself. In 2008, he promised to provide 10,000 jobs for Edo State youths.
If the local government and the state government pull those resources together, I want to guarantee you, give you no less than 5 to 10,000 jobs.
But 6 years after, Oshiomhole has not created one permanent job. Rather, he gave false hope to over 7,000 young men and women under his deceptive Edo Youth Empowerment Scheme, codenamed Edo Yes, which in all intent and purpose amounts to casual labor where the jobs are unsecured and the laborers also not entitled to benefits, including gratuity. These youths have since realized that Edo Yes job is wrapped in deceit, and rather than improve their life, many of them, graduates, have been turned into laborers and beggars. The Edo Yes job is a far cry from Governor Oshiomhole's promise to provide productive and sustainable employment. Surely, this is inconsistent with the standard of the International Labour Organization, ILO, and Nigeria Labour Congress, NLC. Governor Adams Aliyu Oshiomhole must stop the casualization of Edo State youths. We call on ILO, NLC, and other well-meaning Nigerians to appeal to Governor Adams Aliyu Oshiomhole to listen to the plight of Edo Yes staff by regularizing their employment. The youths are not the only ones at the receiving end of Governor Oshiomhole's purposeless administration. Edo State's sporting fortunes and glory have been battered to a point where she can no longer participate in national sports festivals. The only attention sports has received in 6 years is the artificial football turf at Dr. Samuel Ogbemudia Stadium. Bendel Insurance Football Club, once the pride of Edo people, has been left in relegation during Oshiomhole's tenure.
Tomorrow, when we come for the violence, nobody go work here.
Why do you want to see? Are they
violent? Just say you want us to address us. So we're not going to go answer you. We only give you respect now because we came for dialogue and this. We don't come here to come FIFA, take her to one office or the other. Tomorrow. No one office, that is not our work.
It will interest Edo people to know that while Oshiomhole refused to pay the salary of insurance footballers, he paid 50 million naira to his kinsman, coach Amadu Shaibu, as signing fee for a grassroots soccer initiative that never saw the light of the day. It is taking 6 years plus to complete the renovation of the swimming pool at Ogbemudia Stadium after the contract was awarded in 2009. The governor, who has become one and the same with promise and fail, boasted during his inauguration that our people deserve decent and affordable shelter, and so the provision of housing to the various strata of our society will be an important part of our agenda. The only thing that has happened in the housing sector is the allocation of prime lands and issuance of certificate of occupancy by Governor Oshiomhole to faceless housing estate developers. We challenge him to explain to Edo people why he is in the habit of incessant waiver of costs and fees attached to certificate of occupancy for certain individuals. On June 1st, 2013, Governor Oshiomhole granted Alhaji Aliko Dangote a staggering 1,089 million naira waiver for a certificate of occupancy. Edo people are eager to know those who acted as agents to the company, how much was paid to the persons that facilitated the governor's approval for the waiver. Is it true that Dangote showed appreciation for waiver with 300 million naira to the Oga at the top? What has happened to the fertilizer factory the governor told Edo people his newfound friend Dangote will bring to Edo State? What has also happened to the Shoprite construction that Oshiomhole laid the foundation stone over a year ago in Benin City? These are all part of Oshiomhole's failed promises. Mahatma Gandhi once said that the greater the power, the greater the abuse. So it seems with Governor Adams Aliyu Oshiomhole of Edo State, as he may have thrown caution to the winds in his reign as the ruler of Edo State. Investigations reveal that Edo House in Abuja, built by His Excellency Chief Lucky Nosakari Igbinedion, is managed by a company called Waybridge Nigeria Limited with registration number 706625. It will be good for Governor Oshiomhole to confirm or deny in the spirit of Freedom of Information Act and clear the air on the allegation that one of his in-laws, his daughter's husband, is behind Waybridge Nigeria Limited, a company that collects 54 million naira annually for services not rendered. We challenge Oshiomhole, who prides himself, to submit himself to a morality test against the backdrop of the numerous corruption petitions pending against him in EFCC and ICPC. If he fails, we will lead Edo people to force him to do just that, or in the alternative, we shall wait for his immunity to lapse next year. Governor Adams Aliyu Oshiomhole is a master in the use of logic and rhetoric for his own self-seeking benefit. Whereas a true leader is concerned with truth always, Oshiomhole merely focuses on deceit. Truth is what he can get away with, but not anymore, as he will soon explain to Edo people what he has done with their commonwealth. Can Oshiomhole deny the fact that he has personal interest in Raycon Company Nigeria Limited and Heartland Nigeria Limited, two major beneficiaries of road contracts in the state? In 2013, Governor Adams Aliyu Oshiomhole directed Edo State Oil and Gas Producing Areas Development Commission to award the construction of a 10-kilometer Egun to Uyinwen Road in Ikpogba Oka local government area for a whopping sum of 2 billion naira. Experts have argued that the contract sum is inflated considering the fact that the road is a single lane and without drains or streetlights. The road has since been abandoned despite the payment of 80% contract sum. The gains arising from the inflated cost of this project were shared by Governor Oshiomhole, Osarodion Oge, the then Chief of Staff, and Honorable Philip Shaibu, the majority leader in Edo State House of Assembly. Raycon has several other contracts across the state. Can Oshiomhole deny the allegation that his choice for selected bidding is a source he uses to collect bribe from Raycon, Hitech, Heartland, SCAF, and other contractors working in the state? Dr. Simon Imonkemen, former SSG to Oshiomhole, and Mr. Imabinu, former chairman of SUBEB, are currently facing criminal trial by EFCC for 300 million naira they illegally wired the salary account of SUBEB to projects where kickbacks were collected from the contractors to pay certain percentage of their contract payment to Adam Oshiomhole's governorship campaign account in 2012. The existing housing estates in the state were built by late Professor Ambrose Ali and Governor Lucky Nosakare Igbinedion, who constructed two housing estates, Yekuba and Igwosa. Like the prodigal son in the Bible, Governor Adams Aliyu Oshiomhole has embarked on a wasteful mission to sell Edo State properties.
His aim is to humiliate the University of Benin and humiliate the Edo people by his unbecoming actions. And we are saddened by it. And everyone should know that by his actions, the APC has come to an end in Edo State.
Yes! State government, those that make peaceful change impossible, make violent change inevitable. We are ready, the community are ready. We condemn the act of Oshiomhole because this is man, inhumanity to man.
Despite the outcry that trailed his unpopular decision to sell Edo House in Lagos, Oshiomhole is unrelenting in his profligate bid to sell government properties at giveaway prices. Edo people are eager to know those the governor gave all the houses and lands seized from federal government, including the official residence of Professor Osayuki Oshodin.
In my house in the night, all I see, I just saw people pulling down, started shouting, God, I'm a widow, give me today, let me just pass. What is going on? Nobody is talking. They say it's order from government, governor, breaking everywhere. No notice, I just say, God, please, I pleaded, look at my leg. I was kind of knelt down, begging. I slept in my neighbor's house. That's how I'm removing my teeth now.
Sound went into our soup. The food we prepared for the week is gone. The pots were demolished. We are human beings. We are not animals. And this is democracy. There's no democracy here now. Even when the armies were in charge, they can't do this to fellow human beings. And we are even neighbors. We went twice to vote for Oshiomhole from here to that center twice. We never went to him, give us a bottle of mineral. Look at what they are using to pay us.
Only for me to get home, I saw that the demolition exercise was on with bulldozer. I don't know where the governor got tats from. Smoking Igbo, Indian hair, and everything. They were everywhere, both policemen and all. And they said we must move our things out. That's yesterday evening. When there was no prior notice, we started begging.
Thousands of Edo women who have been demonstrating against his administration are also interested in knowing how much the governor paid for the parcel of land.
This land belongs to our Omonoba son. Now he get her. So we can't say make him leave him. Oh, Tolan, my boy, Dena. Oh, Tobia, Ravena, no.
No, you're buying me, Tobia, no. I want to buy two questions here.
This land is for the Oba. Anything that belongs to the Oba belongs to the son.
My lawyers have requested for documentation from the state. Or is it a personal property? Whichever one it is, they should show proof. You cannot use force to tell me not to step on land that is mine. If you say it's yours, then you show proof of it.
He sees from Prince Ekben Eredia-Uwa at Okoro Otun Avenue, GRA, Benin City, on which the governor is presently erecting one of his personal houses. We challenge Governor Oshiomhole to deny the fact that his crusade to dispossess the federal government workers of their properties was fired by his inordinate burning desire to allocate all the properties to himself. Is it true that the governor allocated the Okoro Otun land to himself at a giveaway price of 23 million naira against the market value of over 100 million naira? Does this not amount to insider's dealing? Is this not corruption? If we may ask, what is Oshiomhole's attraction to government landed properties? Why is he in a hurry to sell off every single unit, including Edo House in Abuja, which was constructed by Governor Lucky Igbinedion's administration? How come Oshiomhole is busy allocating the choice properties in government reservation area to himself while pretending that he's fighting for our interest? What happened to the Union Homes Ownership Scheme and the 64 million naira contributed by civil servants to the account of Ministry of Lands and Survey? Who owns the former Guinness Guest House property along Reservation Road next to Chief John Odigi Oyegun's house? Is it true that Governor Adams Aliyu Oshiomhole paid over 350 million naira to purchase the said property? These are some of the questions by Edo people begging for answers from the self-styled comrade governor. Edo people expect Oshiomhole to lead by example and not by deception. Is it not true that Oshiomhole collects over 400 million naira monthly as security vote? An inconsistent person is illogical in his thoughts or actions. He behaves in inconsistent ways and also lacks the will to conclude a purpose that could form a harmonious whole. He is fickle-minded and impulsive. The general overview of the policy framework of Governor Adams Aliyu Oshiomhole's administration exhibits a high level of policy inconsistency and somersault.
If now one person where God creates, we get only one head. Same thing, get only two eyes, Korokolo like me, like you. Elect no pass two, like you, like me. He had no pass two. If he could get the kind man to live in one man, and then the rest of all, we get for small, small, 50 by 50. As you take land, that's what you will take pay for it. This tax is for people who are living in some part of the GRA.
But the future of achievement cannot be compromised, even at the expense of election. The competency test will go on, and I hope the teachers will comply.
There were teachers who were assumed to be ghosts, and for 2 months they were not paid. Now, following subsequent investigation, I'm informed that about 300 of them have been established as teachers that do exist, and they have since been redeployed.
Not tomorrow again, turn around again as a state executive to come around and tell the teachers to go for competency test, to usurp 930 teachers, and the implementation scheme for their emoluments were not done before now. But because of political frolics of political mercantility, so all we are seeing now is that you can fool some people sometimes, but you cannot fool the conscience of Edo people all the time.
After wasting the taxpayers' money, you finally now realize, because the competency test was unpopular in Ekiti State, the governor of this state, Mr. Adams Osumule, thinks that he governs regrettable, uncivilized, and unintelligent Edolites. But I challenge him anytime, any day.
We want to advise the comrade governor of Edo State to always shun the philosophy of Machiavellianism and Mephistophelianism when taking decision that has to do with people.
He runs a government of ad hocism. For instance, the APC administration has peddled different figures as the construction cost of the 7-kilometer airport road project. At one point, the people were told that the total cost was 12 billion naira, and at another, the cost was put by the governor at 17 billion naira. The average cost of the two figures gives 14.5 billion naira, and this translates to over 2 billion naira per kilometer. Experts' information show that Airport Road is the most expensive road to be constructed by any government in Nigeria. As the tenure of Governor Adams Aliu Osumule winds down, Edo people will soon know the real figure his government expended on the contract. Edo people are protesting the non-disclosure of the numerous contracts awarded to high-tech construction company, which is owned by Senator Ahmed Bola Tinubu, the controller of APC. Although Governor Adams Aliu Osumule has tried to cover up the stench oozing from the corruption-infested contracts, Edo people have resolved to ask questions in their bid to find answers. Edo people are anxious to know the connection between Governor Osumule and Hani Associate, the project consultant in charge of all contracts in the state, including universal basic education school projects, road construction, Millennium Development Goal projects, and every other contract awarded by MDAs. Is it true that Governor Osumule is one of the promoters of the company? Is it also true that the proceeds from the overinflated consultancy fee collected from contracts is presently being used to construct a hotel next door to Benin Club Golf Section? Is it not true that the same consultant solely supervised the collapsed Central Hospital without recourse to structural engineers? Why do you still retain him if not for the financial proceeds he faithfully remits to you? Is it true that the ongoing beautification, planting of grass and flowers at the five junctions in Uselu has swallowed more than 900 million naira? On April 11, 2011, Governor Adams Osumule announced to the world that the Benin City Water Storm project will cost 31 billion naira. Today, the contract sum has risen to 150 billion naira. We are also told that the completion date is unknown. The uncertainty surrounding the cost, scope, and completion date of the stormwater project is a reflection of the deception in Osumule's relationship with Edo people. The Ministry of Environment has become notorious for overinflation of contract costs and quantity with the full knowledge and approval of an insatiable governor.
This is the only access road where they pass. If to say they're not going to do them, or high tech when they give the contract to Nogo, for not cut this, now machine they take cut the road. Since that and there are so many hazards now we are suffering here. See our street, erosion don't cut everything.
The flood has driven all my tenants. My children and I have been taking refuge at Uselu Motor Park since 3 a.m. this morning. Nowhere to cook and eat.
Lane 1, Lane 2, Lane 3 was awarded in 2009. By the Kubaka, it was led administration of the Kubaka. That was in 2009. So, and it was for 2 months completion, for 40 million naira. So after about Immediately after flag off, which was shown in the media, the contract, the project was abandoned.
Looking for money and new acquisitions. The cost of erecting streetlights and their maintenance will shock Edo people when this Oshiomole and his gang of looters are finally brought to justice. We are scandalized that a man who prides himself as the people's governor takes delight and pleasure to ride in helicopters around the state at the slightest opportunity. During the groundbreaking ceremony of Queen Ede Guli Erosion Reclamation Project in Benin City, Governor Oshiomole came in two helicopters. While he flew in one, the other came with sultry daughters of Eve who accompanied him as exotic escorts. Oshiomole's ostentatious lifestyle has no limit. Oga Governor, is it true that your choice drink is Dom Perignon Rosé, which sells for 100,000 naira a bottle? Is it true that you lodge in the most luxurious 7-star Burj Arab Hotel, where an average room rate per night is 977,000 naira each time you're in Dubai for your frequent adventures? If these are true, isn't this a betrayal of your khaki attire? Isn't this a betrayal of the trust the long-suffering people of Edo reposed in you? Is this the reason that Edo state debt, internal and external, has risen to over 80 billion naira? Truth must be told. Edo State has never witnessed this level of recklessness. Today, Edo State is one of the most indebted states in Nigeria. In the spirit of Governor Adams Aliu Oshiomole's promise to Edo people on November 12, 2008, wherein he said, "My administration will exercise zero tolerance for corruption. We will run an open, transparent, and accountable government." We encourage him to make public the circumstances surrounding the contract collapsed and the reaward of the Central Hospital project. Edo people want to know the persons behind the contract. How much is the contract sum for the construction work and the fittings? Is it true that the workers in the hospital project have also been deployed to the controversial land on Okoro Otu, GRA, Benin City, where the governor is building yet another personal mansion? In the past 6 years, Governor Adams Aliu Oshiomole has capitalized on an impoverished band of local people to help him entrench himself as the most authoritarian and oppressive ruler in the history of Edo State. To our governor, Edo people are for sale. To keep the masses from asking questions, Oshiomole resorts to the distribution of jeeps to politicians and some chiefs, textile materials to market men and women, dishing out cash to vociferous groups, including some pressmen, in order to have his way. Sadly, Oshiomole's rampant penchant to buy popularity has left the very poor people he swore to protect and provide for even poorer. Between 2008 and 2015, Governor Oshiomole did little to change the lives of our youths, men and women. The microcredit scheme administered by the State Ministry of Commerce has become another hub in Oshiomole's administration. Governor Adams Aliu Oshiomole should account for the 500 million naira Bank of Industry small-scale industry loan that has vanished into private pockets. We challenge Oshiomole to parade the beneficiaries of this loan. Governor Adams Aliu Oshiomole's deception knows no bounds.
No more produce! No more produce!
He will stop at nothing to hoodwink unsuspecting Edo masses. On Wednesday, March 4, 2015, Oshiomole gathered over 3,000 welders in the state to Government House, where he announced that his administration has earmarked 50 million naira loan for members of the Welders Union. A simple arithmetic shows that each welder will access 16,000 naira. Again, this is a clear case of deception by Governor Oshiomole. He says one thing while he does the opposite. It is on record that Oshiomole once asserted never to embrace tokenism in his developmental plan. If we may ask, what impact will 16,000 naira have on the business of each welder? in Edo State. Like every other project that have been executed by Oshiomhole in the state since 2008, this is another rudderless plan that will lead nowhere. His latest promise is informed by his dwindling popularity with the people. Less than 15 months to Oshiomhole's exit from Government House, he cannot point to one single economic or developmental plan in any of the sectors. Every single action is based on Oshiomhole's impulsive decision. The state economic team led by Godwin Obaseki has become his private investment firm that channels ill-gotten wealth to offshore accounts. The Bendel Brewery Limited, which was a beehive of economic activities in 2008, has since gone under the hammer of Oshiomhole's mismanagement and lack of attention. Over 2,000 workers have been sent home, just as several others have been dispatched to their untimely grave due to lack of care. The Nigerian Observer, that was revived in 2000 by Governor Lucky Igbinedion and sustained by Governor Osaheme Osunbo, is now completely run down due to government neglect of the flagship newspaper company. The same fate has befallen Edo Line Transport Company Limited, that was closed down by Governor Adams Aliu Oshiomhole in 2009 because the workers protested against the poor working conditions in the place and unpaid salaries.
26 months, no salary. My landlord Nasef, he doesn't want to pack my load out. As I tell you now, my wife not there with me again. No money to even, not because of the reason. So he's waiting with a beggar for me, come give us some food.
If Oshiomhole's administration finds it difficult to keep the industries he inherited afloat, how then can he conceptualize or build new ones? Pipes supplied to the state government through the African Development Bank many years ago for Benin Waterworks have been fraudulently sold on the orders of the governor and the proceeds shared by the governor and his cronies.
Pray, oh God! Lord, you said they shall surely gather, but not by you. They that gather against our Israel will decree their fall.
Again, this is a case of his actions being inconsistent with his perceived antecedent. A labor man ordinarily should be a friend of the workers and will struggle to keep industries alive at all costs. Sadly, soon after Oshiomhole assumed office, he burnt the ladder with which he climbed into Dennis Osadebe Avenue. One after the other, Oshiomhole either chased away or abandoned all those that assisted him to realize his goal to become the governor of Edo State. Edo workers in Edo State have taken solace in Al Capone's statement that a friend in power is a friend lost. We totally disagree with Governor Adams Aliu Oshiomhole that the state finance is poor because his brazen spending habit on insignificant activities in the state betrays his claim. Several weeks after the opposition People's Democratic Party, led by Chief Dan Obi, displayed some government vouchers for foreign trips ranging from 22 million naira for 10 members of the assembly, 22 million naira for chief of staff and some aides, and 134 million naira that he approved for a 3-day visit to Chicago, USA, Edo people have not seen or heard any rebuttal of the documents. Aside from these, Oshiomhole and Godwin Obaseki collected 14 million naira and 17 million naira for picnic in New York and Miami, Florida, USA. Oshiomhole also gave 76 million naira and 66 million naira to Buhari and Tinubu as fees for cutting tape during the commissioning of some projects in the state. Oshiomhole has kept suspicious silence, which is unlike him. We are also disturbed that Oshiomhole, in his attempt to look for headings that he can use to defraud the state, claims to have repaired a toilet in Government House with 10,048,000 naira. This is most embarrassing. How can Edo people believe or sympathize with Governor Oshiomhole when he is spending the state's taxpayers' money to fund the presidential campaign of the APC candidate? How can Edo State judiciary workers give up on their demand for financial autonomy when the news of how Comrade Adams Aliu Oshomole lost a whopping ₦500 million to Bola Tinubu's boys in his desperate bid to be nominated running mate to General Buhari?
Where the judiciary staff have resumed work, they are in their different offices, still trying to settle down one or two things. But I think this is an ill wind that has not blown anybody any good at all. Government should learn to be responsible and obey court orders so that everybody can live peacefully.
While waiting patiently for Oshomole's last day in office, when his immunity would have lapsed, Edo people demand to know how Khaki Master acquired properties all over the world. It is the people's right to know. Although Governor Oshomole has tried very hard to downplay the fact that since becoming governor, he has acquired a more expensive taste, we caution him to be guided by history that it will be difficult for him to enjoy the comfort of his luxurious homes even after leaving office. The current travails of looters of public funds should serve him as hard lessons. In the spirit of our manifest benevolence, Edo people may find a place in their heart to forgive Oshomole if he declares all such hidden properties now. Nigerians are stunned that despite his earlier comments that the army is a guarantee for peaceful elections, Oshomole is now condemning the idea of deploying soldiers to provide security at elections. For the avoidance of doubt, this is what Governor Oshomole said in his broadcast to the people of Edo State.
All those routes put joint military police patrol to block and to inspect any vehicle that is going to Central, whether through Edo South, through the East, through the River Niger, all those routes. I read this morning Honorable Minister Godidabe say whether we want to use the military to read.
The army is here to deal with troublemakers. The only people who need to be worried are those who intend to cause trouble. As the governor of Edo State, I believe we need the army to complement the efforts of the police. I remember that under our Operation Thunderstorm, the army has been involved in complementing the efforts of the police to provide internal security. So don't allow anybody to fool you that army is going to harass you to prevent you from voting. No, the army is here to assist you so that your vote will count. Now, Nigerians will want to know from Oshomole and his APC leaders what has changed. Edo people are embarrassed by Governor Oshomole's unpredictable character and his scheming nature. We recall with grief and concern how Governor Oshomole was hired to fight alongside PDP against the Nigeria Labour Congress and Nigerians in 2011. His craftiness and deception caught up with him at the Trade Union Congress, and his Action Congress of Nigeria condemned him for abandoning them mid-sea. Chief Jide Awe of ACN in Ekiti State referred to Oshomole as a confused man over a statement that Nigeria will collapse if fuel subsidy is not removed. Mr. Adams is confused. If you see what happened in Edo State, you will know that Oshomole did not speak on behalf of his people. The TUC chairman in Ekiti State, Comrade Kolawole Olaya, in anger described Oshomole as a betrayal. He said, Oshomole's acceptance to serve in the Subsidy Reinvestment and Empowerment Program Board meant he was against the masses. He added that Oshomole has joined the political leaders to rob the workers of their welfare. Any more doubt that Oshomole is a master of deception? Governor Adams Aliu Oshomole rode to power on the wings of a doctrine of one man, one vote, and the state even spent huge resources to launch the campaign prior to his re-election in 2012. But the outcome of the local government council elections conducted in 2013 by Oshomole further exposed him as a man that lacks the capacity to keep to his promise. The crisis that greeted the election threw the state into confusion. More disgraceful was the abracadabra that took place in Esan Northeast, the stronghold of Chief Tony Anini. Voting was still ongoing when Governor Oshomole compelled the chairman of Edo State Electoral Commission to announce a fabricated result. The situation in his Etsako West local government turned tragic when factional ACN members sighted the governor at the polling center. Oshiomhole, who drove himself in his cowboy Wrangler Jeep, scampered away in the midst of gunshots and shouts of Oshiomhole Ole. Thief had rented the air. Governor Oshiomhole's rhetoric of accusing PDP of election rigging reminds us of the case of Ketso calling pot black. It is instructive to note that the crisis in Edo State APC were caused by Governor Adams Aliu Oshiomhole's desire to rig his preferred persons into elective office. According to Comrade Governor, a political miscreant is a politician that doesn't play by the rule. Going by his definition, Nigerians are safe to call Oshiomhole a miscreant, since he ordered ACN leaders to work against Malamnuhu Ribadu, the ACN presidential candidate in 2011. Edo people are known for their heterogeneous but unique culture hinged on respect for elders and traditional institutions. It is in this contest that we find Governor Adams Aliu Oshiomhole's desire to insult elders, some old enough to be his father, without restraint, out of place.
Going to be tied for that red roof to come. People like Esama that has his house from one street to the end. That all those people that have TP houses in Jerry, they are the ones that will pay.
In that same city, you have one man who occupies 10,000 square meters. From the end of the street to the other. That is what Philip said, for which they want to crucify him. The truth must be told as a Catholic.
That in its essence has defeated the credibility of such a being. Even certain personalities were targeted, and it's against the rule of the, it's against the norm of the parliament, it's against the sanctity of the parliament. And for me, such a law is ineffective. Well, I think the error has been made. I will advise the assembly, which is my primary constituent, to go back into their share.
Oshiomhole needs to be reminded that the track of the elephant cancels those of the antelope. When the breeze blows on November 12, 2016, the ugly nyash of a dirty fowl will be exposed. A word of wisdom for the emperor in Osadebe Avenue. A man who listens to the voice of the elderly is like a strong tree. The one who turns a deaf ear is like a twig in the wind. A twig in the wind, Oshiomhole now seems, with the harvest of protest against the APC administration in Edo State. Every day, different interest groups, market women, teachers, students, lawyers, drivers, and even insane persons are leading protest against a governor that has ruled our people with so much deception. Lawrence Olivier, the poet, may have had Governor Adams Aliu Oshiomhole in mind when he wrote, "If you can fake sincerity, you can fake anything." In the final analysis, it is instructive for Governor Adams Oshiomhole to note that when a tyrant dies, his rule is over. When a martyr dies, his rule begins.
Who wanna know on the land? What?